It was last month you said that you believe President Biden is likely to win a second term. You've said this week that you don't have any concerns about his health, as other folks have raised questions. We have, since that debate performance, though, we've seen the biggest shift in polls here in the U.S. away from him and towards former President Trump that we've seen to date. Do you still believe that he is likely to win?
I'm not someone that is able to say how will be the outcome of American elections, but I think it would be a big mistake to underestimate the president. He is successful in doing the necessary things, for instance, in organizing the NATO alliance, and his leadership was very important in the last years and months, and also preparing this very meeting here in Washington. And he is also a successful campaigner. So I think it is the American people that will take a decision. And I just can tell you from my perspective, as someone that is speaking with Biden, he is very focused and he is very intensely doing what a president of the United States has to do for leading the alliance.
Can I ask, because you've been in a sort of unique position this week, you've been meeting with him, you're watching him work. Have you seen any moments at all in your latest interactions with him that tell you in any way he is not up to another 4 years?
No.
And can I also ask, did you watch the debate that has created so many headlines here?
Yes, I did.
You did?
To be honest, everyone in Europe is very much interested in the politics within the United States, because the United States are the strongest superpower in the world, and it's our most important ally, so we are trying to understand what goes on.
And as you watched it, nothing that you saw gave you any concern or reason for pause?
I think that he made his point, and he argued why it is necessary to work on a good cooperation globally without friends and allies of democratic states, and he was very clear and focused on questions of national politics.